Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Boston University Terriers and the Dayton Flyers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Flyers should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. Number one, reward your big men for running the court. Get them some easy buckets in transition. Next, keep the mental mistakes to a minimum. Turnovers could be the story of this one, baby. Thirdly, play as a five-man unit defensively. Have rhythm. Be ready to rotate. Help one another on penetration.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. The small forward receives the pass. Number 15 fakes the shot. The point guard receives the ball with a deep shot from outside.
Take that basketball with that good defensive rebound. They need to get out and run their lanes now.
On the outside, the small forward handles the feed. This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Looking for a screen on top and got it.
Trying to go inside.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
They look to get it to the inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Number 54 handles the pass. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Number 32 picks up the foul. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. From left of the circle, way off target. Tries one from three-point land. Off the rim and no good. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
He makes a good move using the pro hop and draws the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Gets the first. Gets two at the charity stripe.
They scored seven in a row.
Dumps it in. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. He went right through that double team.
Hey, let's see if they decide to double next time down.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
For the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
They'll work it around the arc. There's a double team waiting there.
You got to let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit. Tries to get the D to bite. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. He bombs from outside. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Gave it up. From way outside. Drains it. Looks like the defender's a little bit tired out there.
This is no time to be tired. Get a sub if you need a break.
Trying to feed inside. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get gets a hand in the way. Turnaround jumper. They still don't score.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Way off target. And he scores despite the hang.
Up and inside.
He shoots from left of the circle. Off the rim and no good. They move it into the front court. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
Number one goes to the line for the first time. Count it. Free throws go. Number two is feeling great out there right now.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Sets a screen for his teammate. Looking for a good shot. From the top of the key, way off target. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
And off the mark. Boston University are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
He was doing a great job pressuring the ball and decided to go for the steal. A questionable decision, though, on his part because it resulted in a foul.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
Comes up empty. On the dribble, gives it up. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. Gave it up. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Number 33 comes up with it. They push it up on the break. Makes it. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They work the perimeter.
The frustration right there.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
Glad that's what happened when the defense is too aggressive and looking for the steal.
High post flashes for the opportunity. Decided against the open post and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block. Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
On the outside. Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick.
Pushing that basketball.
The ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Inside. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Working it around the perimeter. Let's it fly. The Terriers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Braddy's on fire.
At the end of the first half, the Flyers are down by 12. Dick, we've got a close one here tonight, my friend. Give us your highlight of the night so far.
I picked the kind of highlight that only a coach can love, Brad. His team working the ball down low to their big man for the inside basket.
We're about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's go down and see how this one unfolds. Number 32 is having, I guess, an average game.
He didn't have a great first half, but as a star player, he knows how to step it up and get them back into this one. Look for him to flip the switch on in the second half and try to make things happen.
All right, Dick, we're going into the second half, and, you know, this gets down to somebody's going home and somebody gets to play on.
I think you and I have seen over the years what separates the teams that can march on and win six in a row, the ability to handle pressure, the ability to play with poise, and be able to finish games.
Turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Goes up for two. In and out. Looking for a good shot. And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
The skip pass is picked off, and the ball goes out of play. They work it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Post flasher is open. Takes away the pass. The ball goes out of play. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
In the paint. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
With the fake. That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR. Hey, where's Mr. Petty? Dump it inside.
For two. Gets it to go. Applying pressure. The shooting guard gets the ball.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
Gave it up. He intercepts it. Hammers it down.
He's a high riser. Sensational, baby.
Dickey really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Stolen away for the deuce. Too strong. Number 32 is pounded on his way up. Dickey V, did you see that? That was a great play, but look at him now. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders, that's awesome, Brad.
He goes to the free throw line. Misses his first shot. Hits the second. Shoots from downtown. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
Number 31 is charged with the foul. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Hits that one. On the inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
There's the pick. There's the roll. For two. Doesn't go. Number Number two.
Knocks it home and one.
What a poor job defensively. Nobody stopped the penetration of the ball. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Picks off the lazy pass. The point guard gets the pass. He takes the shot from the baseline. The Flyers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
They work it around the perimeter. The shooting guard with the ball.
Double team now, bad angle.
Dick, you gotta love tournament games like this. Great first half, second half's been more of the same, and I don't know, what do you think? The favorite, can he pull it out or not?
Well, I really believe that too. I agree with you, Brad. I think the last few possessions gonna dictate who moves on, survives, advances, and who goes home.
Not getting enough motion on offense in our transition, Brad. Take a look right here. Nobody steps into the driving lane. He allows him to get the crease, the lane, the angle.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go. Rims out. Jumped in front to take it away. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Number two is whistled for the foul. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake and good footwork, keeping his pivot foot down. Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. And he scores it off the glass.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo. Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Steals the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. There's the rejection. He blocks the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. The small forward takes the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. They'll work it around the arc. Kicks it out.
There's the trap.
Fake. goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, 6-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
For two, sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Defense all over him here. Pulls the trigger. Rims out. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. We're about ready to start things up again.
We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. He strokes it. He buries the shot. Thinks about the shot. Number 15 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
He dials long distance. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Looking for a good shot. He launches the bomb. Nope. Shot clock is dead. On the outside.
Give yourself a chance with a score here. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this point of the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Number 13 steps to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Second one is no good. They call for a T.O., Dick.
Hey, time is their worst enemy at this point, Brad. They're going to have to bear down and get some stops, then convert at the other end. It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad. A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. Off the rim and no good. And again, they look to run. Working it around the perimeter.
Look at that spacing.
Kicks it out. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I'll tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Terriers is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.